Its power is growing. Joining me this evening, on my right, Julie Galanti, an artist who makes ink out of plants. Charlie Mollison, a data architect who enjoys the golden age of detective fiction. And their captain, Charles Dundas, a charity chief executive who owns 84 ordnance survey maps. United by a weakness for whiskey, they are the Uisge Beathas. Charles, I, of course, know exactly what your team name means, but just in case anyone doesn't, what is it?
Uisge Beathas is the Scottish Gaelic for water of life, which is what whiskey is.
And did you have a long about your team name?
We tried a few, and we felt that fitted us best.
Have you ever heard anyone except me say Havering?
No.
No.
Well, it's now correct. I've decided.
Okay, good.
Thank you very much for coming all the way to Cardiff. You are facing, on my left, Ian Wang, an auditor who is grade 8 in electric guitar. Chris Nash, a business support analyst who can say the alphabet backwards in 5 seconds. And their captain, Dennis Wang, an actuary who once corrected the flags outside the headquarters of the United Nations. Committed to calculations, they are the crunchers. Dennis, you're clearly a mathematical team. How's your Jane Austen and your snooker?
She's my favourite snooker player.
Are any of you whiskey drinkers?
Nope.
I don't drink at all, so...
Oh, I think you've got a natural advantage. Welcome to you two. Let's play the quiz. Crunchers, you won the toss and you'll be going first. Please choose an Egyptian hieroglyph.
Can we have the lion, please?
Yes, you can. You'll be seeing some pictures. They appear unrelated, but they do have something in common. What is it? Here's your first clue.
Hey, Barney the Dinosaur. We don't have anything on that, do we?
Next, please.
Is that a film?
It's Sean Connery, yeah, but I don't know who the character is. Okay, just want to let you know that. Next, please.
I don't know who that is. Yeah, it could be. It's like Marshall, the lead. I don't know these, Robin. Fine.
Next, please.
Roast beef. That doesn't look fit.
Roast beef.
2 seconds.
Nicknames for nationalities.
They are not nicknames for nationalities, I'm afraid. So a bonus chance for you, Uisge Beathas.
OK. Are they all types of fight?
They are fights. What are we looking at?
You're looking at a Barney.
Mm-hmm.
Is he Trouble, the in Bond film? It's Quarrel.
It's Quarrel. You knew it was a film. I think you knew it was a Bond film. I think this film must come up more often in quizzes than any other film. It's Dr. No, and that character is Quarrel. What about clue three?
I should know.
Well, I should you. He's a host of Top Gear, the former racing driver. Oh. Tiff Needell. And the last one, beef, of course. All slang for each other, for quarrels or fights. Well done, you get a bonus point. What would you like for your own question?
Could we have the water, please?
Yes, you could. Water. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
Next.
Eating breakfast outside.
No. Okay, next. What do they do?
Did she perform blindfolded?
Yes.
We'll go next.
Okay, next.
Oh, knitting.
Yeah, okay. Knitting.
The answer is knitting. Although we've phrased it as yarn crafts, which I'll come to in a moment. Tell me about these clues.
Well, Tom Daly was seen in the audience of an Olympic event knitting.
He's a big knitter, isn't he now, Tom Daly?
Well,
yes, almost known more for the knitting than the diving.
I'm guessing Yoko Ono blindfolded knitted whilst on Top of the Pops.
It was a performance of Instant Karma on Top of the Pops, and she was, well, you see, she said she was knitting, but we've put yarn crafts because expert knitters say that's actually crocheting. And we're the kind of show that respects that kind of difference. They did two performances of Instant Karma. Another one, she's blindfolded with a sanitary towel holding up signs saying breathe. So, you know, it's up to you which your favourite of the performances would be. Holly Golightly, that's obviously the character in Breakfast at Tiffany. She's a keen knitter. And the first one, it's a 15th century painting of the Virgin Mary knitting a sort of red jumper, which seems anachronistic, but look it up and it does exist. Yeah. Crunchers, back to you for a choice.
Can we have the Eye of Horus, please?
Yes, you could. I'm so sorry. It is the music question. You'll be hearing your clues. Here's the first. Lights out in the Wonder Park. Your
sawtooth lover boy was quick off the mark. Next, please. Then...
I can look like a disco ball.
You're a boy. I know that's going to work.
Next, please. I don't know, this is from a soundtrack, maybe? I have no idea.
Western soundtrack.
Let's get another one. Next, please.
Yeah. What's the next?
1 second.
Yeah, like
a beach. Ball? Beach. No, beach activities. Like a
beach
ball,
activities. Really.
Beach activities will do. What did we hear?
Surfing USA by the Beach Boys.
Yes.
The first one's Arctic Monkeys. I think it's Mirabel.
Oh, it's actually Jet Skis on the Moat.
Oh, is it? Oh, okay.
Yes, it is.
Fine.
Yes.
Fine. Well, I don't know the other two.
The second one was We Sail the Ocean Blue from HMS Pinafore. And did anyone recognise that third clue?
Michael Rowe the Boat Ashore.
Michael Row the Boat Ashore, exactly so. So beach activities are more technically perhaps on the water activities, but you can see the beach when doing any of these things. Well done, you get that point. Back to you for a choice.
Could we have the Horned Viper?
Yes, you could. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
Okay, next.
It says there's a little trade with the devil thing. What is that film?
Okay, it's something with red hands or something. Let's go.
Nothing next.
Next.
Is that a French horn? It's
French. It's different. It's
true. I think next.
Yeah, let's go next.
2 seconds.
They're all paperclips.
They're all connected by paperclips. Well done. What can you tell me about the clues?
The French name for a paperclip is a trombone.
It is. I saw you laughing there. I mean, it seems like it's going to be filthy, doesn't it?
Yeah.
French trombone, you feel like, oh, that's not something I want to type into one of those slang websites. In this case, it's simply the word trombone, which means the instrument or a paperclip in French.
The Microsoft Office assistant was Clippy, who would pop up and tell you, it looks like you're writing a letter. Can I help? Kyle MacDonald, is he the chap who traded his way up to a mansion starting with
this? Is it? He had a website. He started with a paperclip and he traded it and traded it and traded it until he had a house in Canada. I can tell you, you see, I think I can see where it went strange. I've got a list here of all the trades he did. This was in 2005. He swapped the paperclip for a pen, the pen for a doorknob, the doorknob for a camping stove, the camping stove for a generator, the generator for a beer keg, the beer keg for a snowmobile. Hang on. Somebody gave him a snowmobile in return for a beer keg, and then it keeps going and going and going, and he ended up with a house in Canada. Amazing. And that first clue, do you know anything about that?
No, I think people wore them as a sign of protest at some point.
Yes, do you know why?
Because it symbolises holding things together in community.
Well, that probably was the reason, you see, although it got a bit confused because people decided that Johan Vala, a Norwegian, had invented the paperclip. But that wasn't what it was about. I think he had invented a paperclip, but not the one we think of today, the one that's the Microsoft symbol. And really, it was just about, you know, a sign of community held together when Nazi Germany invaded Norway. All paperclips, well done. Back to you, Crunchers. What would you like?
Can we have the Twisted Flux, please?
The Twisted Flux. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
It's like backwards.
It could be a word one.
If you reverse the second word, up after, then you get the first. Do you want to get one more and see if it works?
I want to get one more.
Yeah, I think we need to.
Okay, next, please.
Slap up.
Yeah,
slap
it's
up
done.
Slap up
does
meal.
What some trust means then?
Yeah, slap up meal.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, I see, right, yes.
So, yeah, if you reverse the second word and put up after it, then it means the first word.
Look at your team held together like a paperclip. Very well done. Let's have a look at all the clues. You could almost have got this for 5 points. Talk me through it, please.
So a top up. If you reverse pot, you get top. So a top up is a refill. Mm-hmm. A slap up meal is a sumptuous meal. Mm-hmm. Laid up is in bed ill, and then look up.
Look up research. Very well done. 3 points for coming in after two clues. Uisge Beathas, back to you for the two reads. That's all that remains. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
No, next. Okay, next.
Last letters. Don't know.
Nope. Next.
At the start of it.
City.
I mean, it's the outbound part of the postcode. It's like this postcode area.
2 seconds.
What do we think? They all represent the third.
They do not, I'm afraid. So, Crunchers, it's a bonus chance for you.
They precede numbers.
They are all followed by numbers. Talk to me about these clues, please.
Leviticus is the Bible. Last letters game is in countdown. Mm-hmm. Postcodes. I don't know about the calculator.
So, that first one, it is from the 1981 album, which I'm told is the iconic album by Kraftwerk. Or I should perhaps say Kraftwerk. No Kraftwerk fans.
Sure.
Yeah. No, but the song Numbers, the piece Numbers comes after Pocket Calculator. So well done, you get the bonus. And that means at the end of round one, Uisge Beathas have 3 points, the Crunchers have 5. Sequence is time now, and Crunchers, you'll be going first again. What would you like?
Can we have the Horned Viper, please?
Yes, you can. I'll be showing you the first in a series of clues. What would come forth? Your time starts now.
Is it etymology, maybe?
Or just something black. It's a type of something. It's always ringing about.
I don't know.
Next, please.
I don't know what that is.
No, it's just a brand of alcohol or something. I don't know.
Sorry. I think that's just to get the last one.
Next, please.
Like a wooden crane, I don't know. It looks like a whopper with one of the letters changed, but I don't think it's that.
Like
a crawler.
Beewicks.
Is it an instrument? I don't know. It's not a word one, is it?
I don't think so.
No. It doesn't look like a word
one. 1 second.
Right. White from Australia.
That's not the answer, I'm afraid. Do you know over there for a bonus point?
They're all swans. So the fourth one is...
mute.
A mute. Mute swan.
They are all swans, so the fourth one is mute. Very well done. Who's the swan expert?
Charlie.
What's the sequence, Charlie?
I think they're getting larger in size of swan, so...
They're getting larger in terms of population size. So the most common swan in the UK is the mute swan. Are you a swan fan?
I've seen at least 3 of those. I've not seen the Australian.
You'll see them here, swimming about in Cardiff Bay. If you go to Bay, you see lovely swans. How many swans are owned by the monarch?
All mute swans.
No, you see, it's a myth that the king or queen owns all the swans. It's about half the ones on the Thames, I think, are supposed to be the property of the crown, but not all of them. So you get the bonus point and your own question. What would you like?
Can we have the lion, please?
Yes, you can. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
OK, next.
Next.
So it starts with L and ends with something. So, because impressed ends in V, and then vortex starts with V, ends in X.
So it starts with L.
It's because it's 1, 5, 10, so 50, so and it starts L and then it ends in C.
2 seconds.
Julie.
Lyric.
Lyric would be an acceptable answer. We've got logic. What's going on, Julie?
It's the Roman numerals. So there's 1, 5, 5, 10, 10, 50, 50, 100.
Exactly so. These words begin and end with Roman numerals going up in size, so we need anything that starts with an L and ends with a C. Very good. Crunchers, what would you like?
Can we have water, please?
Yes, you can. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Angel Once could be anything, right? Angel the Station. Yeah, it could be that. Oh, it could be something like that, yeah. Maybe.
Next, please. Oh, that's Shaggy.
I think they're going back in time, so it's going to be the first one with Mr. Love, I mean.
I don't know. I don't know Shaggy's discography.
I think it wasn't me. It was before.
Does he have an ensemble called Angel?
It's got to be his first. Angel came after it, wasn't me. It's got to be his first one. I think it's Mr.
Do you want to get another one just to be sure? Mr. Loverman.
I wouldn't. If it's not Mr. Loverman.
You don't know
it. Then it's Mr. Loverman. And if it is, then I wouldn't know what it is.
Okay, so do you just want to go for it?
Let's go for Mr. Loverman. Mr. Loverman?
Unlucky. I'm going to show the third in a sequence to your opponents for a possible bonus point. I think if you don't know,
Shaggy.
You don't know.
I am Shaggy.
A lovely option, but it's not I Am Shaggy, it's O Carolina. What's the sequence?
It's Shaggy song. Shaggy single's going back in time, I think.
Exactly. And why have we picked Shaggy of all the people that we could have four songs by?
I guess probably they're his only four.
He's unusual in having had four number ones. Yeah. So these are Shaggy's four number ones going back to the first one, O Carolina. Although I Am Shaggy, let's hope will be a future hit in years to come. More of a children's one, perhaps, than bombastic. So no points there, but you may have your own question. What would you like?
Can we have the Eye of Horus?
Yes, you could. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
It's 10, Jeremy.
Okay. Next. Yep, next.
King, so König. König.
Is the right answer, and why is that?
It's the cards in German, so 10, Jack, Queen, King.
Exactly so, and why have you put them in German?
For fun?
Just for no reason, just because it's annoying and we've put them in German to see if you can work it out. Do you speak German?
Yes, I do.
And yet you're not a fan of Kraftwerk?
Not so much, no.
Not so much. But very well done, because it gets you the points. Crunchers, what would you like?
Can we have the two reeds, please?
The two reeds. These are going to be picture clues. What would you expect to see in the fourth picture? Here's the first.
That's rather low. Should we just get another one? Could be low, medium, high.
Next.
That's Peter Dinklage.
That's Peter Dinklage. So
Rob Lowe, Peter Dinklage. Maybe Rob Peter, maybe? I don't know what that would be.
No, yeah, or like Tyrion. No, it's not him.
No, it's not. I think it's just Peter Dinklage.
Lowe.
Should we get another one?
No. Yeah, next, please.
Toupee?
Taking off a toupee.
Toupee or wig?
Toupee.
Wig.
Rob Lowe, Peter Dinklage, toupee.
No, Rob Peter wig.
No, it could be Rob Peter wig, yeah.
Oh, robbing Peter to pay Paul.
OK, so what should we say?
Is this a toupee?
What should we say?
Yeah, a picture of Paul Weller.
I mean, why would you have Paul Weller when you could have lovely Paul Rudd? I enjoyed watching you going, Rob, Peter, toupee. What do these things have in common? And what do they have in common?
It's a phrase, yeah. Rob, Peter, toupee, Paul.
Exactly so. Has anybody seen Mental Samurai?
No.
It's a quiz show hosted by Rob Lowe. He's become a quiz show host. I don't understand that at all. He was a big film star. He must have made a fortune from The West Wing. Why is he doing a quiz show? Who'd want to be a quiz show host? What's the matter with him? I'm baffled by that decision. Back to you, Uisge Beathas, for the last question of the round, Twisted Flax. Can you untwist it? I will show you the first in a sequence, and it's this.
Okay. Capitals, neighbouring countries.
OK, next.
Where's Power Kid?
Where is Power Kid? Was there somewhere that there was moved in warfare or something?
Next.
Oh, it spells out capital. So C-A-P-I-T-A-L-S. So V-L-S.
Lima Sofia.
I will accept that answer. What is this sequence?
These are capital cities that the initial letters spell out capitals.
Exactly so. At the beginning, it just says C-A-P-I-T-A. We went with Lusaka, Skopje. What are these the capital cities of?
I don't know.
Skopje, Macedonia.
Yeah.
Yes? Have you come to my quiz without knowing the capital of Zambia?
Yeah.
Yes.
We'll have words later. For now, at the end of round two, the Crunchers have 7 points, Uisge Beathas have 10. It's time for the connecting wall, and Uisge Beathas, you get the chance to go first this time, so please choose lion or water.
Could we have the lion, please?
Yes, you could. 2.5 minutes to solve the lion wall, starting now.
Rapture, joy, happiness.
These films with Jennifer Lawrence.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, so Glee,
Molfin and Epsom are in Sorry.
Yeah, but they're also Waters. Harrogate, Waters, Epsom, Malvern, Bath. And then, or shall we just do it?
Well, I think you...
Well,
Felicity and Delight are the kind of the same.
Glee,
Rapture and Bliss,
Glee,
maybe?
Felicity, yeah.
And where the...
Rapture or Delight.
Yeah.
Five of them, so...
Rapture.
Right. So we've got Waters, Bath, Buxton, Epsom, Malvern. But okay, so Angel, Delight, Angora.
Coffee, Delight, Coffee, Angel.
Are there. I mean, Coffee and Delight need to be together.
Are they. Angola? Can we change the country?
Oh, change the letter, is it?
Rapper's Delight.
Rapper's Coffee.
Rapper's Angora.
Like Irish coffee, we're doing different.
Turkish Delight.
Turkish Coffee. Turkish Angora's a cat. And Turkish Baths.
Solve the wall. Very well done. What about the connections? Tell me about the first group, Red Sparrow and so on.
These are films with Jennifer Lawrence.
They're films starring Jennifer Lawrence. And the next group, Glee, Bliss, Felicity, Rapture.
They all represent delight.
Well done. All synonyms for each other. Often hard to describe the group without looking for the red herring in a different group to say what they are. And there it is, delight alongside Angora, Bath and Coffee.
Turkish.
You can put Turkish before all of them. And the last group, Epsom, Malvern, Harrogate and Buxton.
So these are all spa towns, so they're waters.
They're spa towns, exactly so. So that is all the connections and the bonus. You get the maximum 10 points. Very well done. Let's bring in the other team now, give them the other wall and see how they get on. You'll be getting the water wall crunchers. You've got 2.5 minutes to solve it, starting now.
Right, Splash is a Philadelphia, they're all Tom Hanks films.
Yes, Big.
There's also Big, yeah.
Splash and...
he's not in Titanic, he's not in Crash.
What else is he? Is
Finch, maybe? Try Finch.
Finch. Finch.
OK, maybe not. Let's look at other things.
Astronomical, Big.
OK, yeah, Astronomical Unit, SI Unit. Yeah, Power Unit.
Fast is in the Bigs as well.
Yep.
Yeah. What are the other units? The symbols. Try the symbols, maybe. Kai-Hat, Crash, Hi-Hat, Splash and
crash, Ride.
Ride
and Splash, yeah. But, yeah, I don't think there's any red Okay, so...
Inferno is a film. Oh, I think the Tom Hanks films will be Philadelphia Inferno.
Oh, yes, because it's the Dan Brown
Big, and then... Yep. But maybe leave it
big
until...
And...
Oh, actually,
big
I don't know.
Big and... No, no,
oh, no, there's got to be another one, because Splash has already gone into the symbols.
We lost Splash.
Let's,
okay.
Let's go back to maybe
Finch,
the units
maybe?
Or the Bigs. Yeah, it could be Finch, yeah. I think it might be Finch, actually.
Vast, Mammoth,
it is Finch. It is definitely Finch. Right, I know it's Finch.
So we've got...
What, a military unit? You think
maybe
there's a
military unit, yeah.
The unit of power.
A power unit, maybe?
There's a power unit. So
well, a unit of power.
We've got films and...
Which is the Bigs, right, I think.
And the Bigs. So you want to try this?
I think so. Yeah, okay.
We've got the Bigs.
Yeah, so Mammoth, Vast, Enormous, Titanic.
And then
they're
Tom Hanks.
Yeah.
You've solved the wall. Very well done. Tell me about the connections, starting with Splash, Hi-Hat, and so on.
They're all symbols.
They are symbols. Next group, Astronomical, Power, and so on.
Followed by Unit.
They can be followed by Unit. Enormous, Vast, Mammoth, Titanic.
They all mean Big.
They all mean Big. And the last group, Big, Philadelphia, Finch, Inferno.
This is Tom Hanks films.
Tom Hanks films, yes. Finch, I haven't seen it. It's apparently it's about perhaps the last man on Earth teaching a robot to look after his dog. I trust Tom Hanks it'll be heartwarming, but it sounds so just kind of bleak.
Yeah.
I haven't watched. Very well done. Nice solution. You get 4 for finding the groups, 4 for the connections. Bonus of 2, that's a maximum 10 points. Let's have a look at the overall scores. The Crunchers have 17 points and Uisge Beathas have 20 points. Missing vowels time now, teams. So fingers on buzzers, please. I can tell you that the first group of disguise clues are all dirty. Crunches?
Dirty Dancing.
Yes, it is. Crunches?
Dirty Harry Callahan.
Correct. Uisge Beathas?
Angels with Dirty Faces.
Yes, it is. Crunches?
Dirty Den Watts.
Well done. Next category, they're rotten. Crunches?
Rotten Tomatoes.
Yep. Uisge?
Rotten Burrows.
Yes, it is. Crunches?
John Lydon.
All Johnny Rotten. Uisge?
Something's rotten in the state of Denmark.
I'm sorry, the consonants are wrong. Crunches, do you know?
Something in the state of Denmark.
I'm afraid we didn't have the rotten there. Next category, of course, they're scoundrels. Crunches?
Long John Silver.
Correct. Uisge Beathas?
Lord Byron.
Yes, it is. Tricky one, this. It's Alec d'Urberville from Tess of the d'Urbervilles. Next clue. Crunches?
Lovejoy.
Yes, it is. Next category, cartoon characters and their voice actors. Uisge?
Bugs Bunny and Mel Blanc.
Yes, it is. The bell has gone for the end of the quiz. Very well done, all of you. Looking at the close final scores, I can tell you that the winners with 25 points are the Crunchers. Uisge Beathas, you finish on 23. It's very close, but you're a great team. You'll get another chance to win through later in the competition. Crunchers, well done. You are straight through. We'll obviously be seeing you later as well. Thank you very much for watching. And coming up next on BBC Two, it's another of those Shakespeare Live productions, you know, where the cameras go to the theatre and beam it directly into your living room. And tonight, it's an all-star performance of A Midsummer Night's Dream with a big BBC Two name in a leading comic role. I hear it's wonderful. And you know what I love about these shows? You can go to the theatre and pay a fortune and then you're sitting far away, you can hardly make out the stage, but with the cameras right up there, you can see everything in detail. So if you'd like a really close look at Michael Portillo's apparently magnificent bottom, that's coming up next on BBC Two.